This runway business is a joke besides a crazy thing to do. The real jobs are on the plate now.
Fearless, passionate, outspoken, refreshingly open about his personal life. These are just some of the ways that people describe Los Angeles City Councilmember Bill Rosendahl. The mayor and Bill's council colleagues go so far as to call him the conscience of the city council.
Let's get this straight. I was the first person to refer to him as the conscience of the city council. And I say that all the time because he is. He cares about social justice. He cares about people who don't have a voice. He cares about the homeless. He's passionate about the people who government sometimes forgets.
Bill will always speak up for those with no voice and fight for those who feel they have no power in city government.
The city has a lot of heart. And one of the things people really like about Bill is that he also has a lot of heart.
I have to smile when I think of Bill. He is such a compassionate person. And the only thing that matches his compassion is his passion for justice and helping the most vulnerable members of our community.
He won't back down. When he believes in something, he's passionate about it, and he'll take a stand, which I really admire.
But what defines Bill Rosendahl? The causes and issues that matter most to him over the years are the cornerstones of his public service. As the voice of the West Side on the City Council since 2005, Bill has been a champion of public safety, mass transit, and traffic improvement projects. He has a strong record of standing up and protecting the environment and our neighborhoods. And he insists on supportive services for the homeless and our returning veterans. Since taking office in 2005, Bill has fought for more affordable housing in our neighborhoods, especially in the precious coastal communities of the 11th District. Developer Tom Safran shares the same vision for Angelenos and teamed up with Bill to build Delray Square, which was named after Bill Rosendahl.
When he approached the building, he told the cameras, the media, the TV stations who were there, see, this is what I believe in should be possible for people, not just the rich, but people who are middle income and lower income. They should have an opportunity to smell the ocean and live in my district, and it shouldn't just be for rich people.
Since his election, Bill has fought tirelessly for our veterans returning from war. He's called for more housing opportunities for homeless vets at the underutilized Veterans Administration campus in West LA. Thanks to constant pressure from Bill, the federal government finally broke ground on renovations to Building 209, a facility that will help homeless vets transition to independent living. Bill also worked with local vets in Pacific Palisades to build the Fisher House, a place where the families of wounded soldiers can live while their loved ones undergo medical treatment for traumatic injuries sustained on the front lines of war.
Yes, he has raised awareness and compassion for our homeless citizens, who are citizens and have the same rights and privileges we all do. But specifically, he was a huge proponent and one of the sole reasons that the Upward Bound shelter surrounded by Del Rey got finished, and that's so far has put 1,000 children off the streets and into permanent homes.
As the wars wrapped up, more homeless vets returned to our soil. Many took part in Rosendahl's Vehicles to Homes initiative. The CD11 program, started by Bill, has helped hundreds of people living in their cars and campers to find permanent housing. Bill discovered an invaluable partner in PATH, People Assisting the Homeless, and with the Los Angeles Homeless Services Authority, helping administer the program.
It was a win-win approach. Basically saying, let's help people who are homeless actually get into apartments. People living in vehicles, people living on the streets, and let's get them into apartments. And if we can do that, we actually reduce homelessness in the district and in the neighborhood. And he has done that. And I actually think the approach that Bill has taken to address homelessness in his district is a model for the rest of the city.
Addressing homelessness was just one of Bill's passions. So was fighting gridlock, which chokes neighborhoods in his West Side district and throughout all of Los Angeles. As chair of the city's transportation committee, Bill has refocused the city's efforts on initiatives that would enhance the coming rail system approved by voters through Measure R. Bill's long-term vision to reduce reliance on the automobile helped shape initiatives that support walkable and bikeable communities, and he directed policy that has helped change the mindset of our car culture and created even safer roads for all modes of transportation. Under Bill's watch, the city implemented a new bicycle master plan, which will guide the development of a bike infrastructure network that will benefit the entire region. Bill led the effort on the Safe Routes to School strategic plan that will leverage greater resources for pedestrian improvements near our schools, and it will engage residents in improving their communities, encourage walking and biking to school. Bill is also credited with implementing the Bicycle Anti-Harassment Ordinance, the first of its kind in the nation. The ordinance legally protects cyclists involved in a collision with a car. Through his YouTube channel, Bill heard about the importance of this law.
And what we've seen is other municipalities, ones that are known as being progressive in a way Los Angeles isn't, such as Berkeley, San Francisco, are copying this ordinance. Like, and it was Bill's. And it's great that they're copying it, don't get me wrong, but this is something that Los Angeles thought of first, and it came from out of Bill Rosendahl's office.
When it comes to public safety, Bill has worked tirelessly to make sure his West Side district has a sufficient number of cops and firefighters to stand up and protect the residents of his district. Crime is down, and Bill has added 25 officers to the summer patrol for the Venice Beach Boardwalk. During the budget crisis, Bill fought for his constituents to have more fire service on the hillsides, the most fire-prone area of the city of Los Angeles.
I think it gave the community in general a sense of security and of safety to know that we have a politician that is more a father than a ruler. He's everyone's friend and he becomes part of the family.
And finally, environmentalists always have the strong support of Bill Rosendahl. Bill championed environmentally friendly projects such as the Grand Canal and Bayonagoon Restoration Project and the Stream Protection Ordinance.
He's been a huge champion for the Biona Wetlands, and we're really fortunate that 150 acres or so are actually owned by the City of Los Angeles. There are another 650 acres that are owned by the State of California, and he's been a champion for all of those wetlands, but particularly the city-owned wetlands. He has empowered us and the community to engage in restoration that is not harmful to the environment.
A fierce supporter of the newly enacted plastic bag ban, Bill also helped expand recycling to apartment buildings and installed recycling bins on our district's public streets.
And Bill was the first person I met who shared my vision of this city. This is what the city can be like, and it's not impossible, and we can make a difference. And we just immediately connected over that, whether it was banning plastic bags, getting LA off coal, fighting to legalize urban beekeeping, banning fracking. I mean, whenever we took an initiative on something, Bill was the first one to sign the petition. He was the first one to say, we can do this.
Standing with environmentalists comes naturally to Bill, especially since he's so connected to his environment. The proud owner of a beehive that sits on what has become somewhat of an urban farm that produces beautiful eggs in colors most people never knew existed. Bill presented half a dozen to Angelenos who did good work in their community. Bill thought the eggs were a great way to show people he cared.
Because I've been to his house on a number of occasions, I've seen the way he loves those chickens he has and the way he takes care of them, and it's very sweet.
When you receive eggs, that is the biggest compliment that one can get. They're homegrown, they're different colors, they're his pride and joy, and he shares them in a very unique way.
You know, there's something special about receiving food from someone, especially food they cultivated themselves, whether it's vegetables from the backyard or he sort of famously gives out eggs to people. We got some the day we shot a video with Bill where a couple of professional bike instructors retaught him how to ride a bike it was the first time he had ridden one in decades. And it was such a festive and happy and fun day. And getting those eggs is sort of a short-term memento because, you know, we ate them. It was just fun.
He is, in my opinion, the master showman. And he has taken his experience from the media and transferred it to the council. Sometimes I sit up and I say, where the heck is Bill going with this? But the people in his district love him because he understands what they want and how they feel.
We will miss Bill Rosendahl and his eggs. We will miss his fearless attitude and his can-do spirit. We will miss his passion and his candid commentaries on life and on politics. We will miss the conscience of the City Council. We will miss Bill Rosendahl's big heart and his warm smile. And of course, we'll miss the way he lets you know when things are
great, 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 great.
Great, 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 great.
Great, 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 great.